Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss chapter 2, globe, latitudes and longitudes. So in this video we learn what is a globe, what is its importance, what are latitudes and longitudes and their importance. So let's start. Globe. A globe is a sphere on which a map especially of the earth is represented. It means globe is a true miniature form of the earth. It rotates around its axis. As you can see the picture, this is your globe, okay, and this line is your axis line, okay. This is your north pole and here it's your south pole. And it moves west to east. Means as you are watching this video, it is moving anti-clockwise. Latitudes, let's see what are latitudes. An imaginary line that divides the globe into two equal parts, northern half and southern half, is known as equator. You can see here in this picture, this line is your equator, this line is your equator. Okay, and it divides the globe, this is your globe, two halves. Theek hai, northern half and southern half, this is your equator. Northern half is known as northern hemisphere and southern half is known as southern hemisphere. Okay, all the parallel circuits from the equator up to the poles are called parallels of the latitudes. As you can see, these are parallels. This one, this one, this one, these are parallels below also, okay. And this equator is also known as 0° latitudes. All parallels north of the equator are called north latitudes and south of the equator are called south latitudes. 90° north, it is written like this, 90° north, okay, and 90° south, N for north, S for south. So 90° north latitude is known as north pole, here you can see 90°, okay, and 90° south latitude is known as south pole below, as you can see. Important parallels of latitudes, okay. On a globe there are so many latitudes that are very important for the study of weather and our earth. These are imaginary lines, but it is divided on the basis of their characteristics, okay. Equator, 0°, as you can see here. North pole, 90° north, you can see here. South pole, 90° south, you can see here. Tropic of Cancer, yes, this 23.5° north, this Tropic of Cancer, theek hai, and Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5° south, this one, and Arctic Circle, 66.5° north, this is your Arctic Circle, and Antarctic Circle, 66.5°, this is your Antarctic Circle, okay. These latitudes are very important to study the earth and globe. Heat zones of the earth, okay, on the basis of their characteristics, on the depending on the motion of the sun, the earth is divided into some heat zones. Let's see what are these heat zones. The midday sun is exactly overhead at least once a year on all latitudes in between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. Therefore this area receives the maximum heat and is called the torrid zone, okay. This is your Tropic of Cancer and this is your Tropic of Capricorn, theek hai, and sun moves in between these two lines, okay. So these area, as you can see, this light greenish area, this area, this area, this is maximum heat during the year, okay. In summer when it is summer in northern hemisphere, sun is in southern hemisphere, sorry, in northern hemisphere. When it is cold in northern hemisphere, sun is in southern hemisphere, okay. So this greenish area, light greenish area, receives maximum heat during the year. Beyond the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, no midday, means sun doesn't go beyond these two lines. Tropic of Cancer means this side, okay, this side, this side. Sun doesn't go, yahan pe sun jata hi nahi hai. So these two areas receive very less heat, okay. And as you can say, suppose sun is here at this point, okay. So rays of the sun will slant, ठीक है, यहाँ पे इसके एंगल्स कम होते जाएंगे, यानी इसकी रेज थोड़ा सा एंगल ऑफ रेज जो है वो डिक्रीज हो जाएगी, ठीक है. सो दीज एरियाज विल रिसीव लेस हीट, दैट्स व्हाई द टेम्परेचर ऑफ दीज एरियाज आर मॉडरेट. सो दीज आर कॉल्ड टेम्परेट जोन, ओके. एज यू कैन सी the area bounded by the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle in the northern hemisphere and the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle in the southern hemisphere have moderate temperatures. These are therefore called temperate zones, okay. As I told you, these areas between Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle. This is your Tropic of Cancer, this is your Arctic Circle. So this area, okay. And in southern hemisphere, between Tropic of Capricorn and Tropic and Antarctic Circle, this area, okay. So these two area receives moderate temperature because sun reaches here, maximum distance here. So from here it receives not very less but moderate temperature, so they are called temperate zones. And area between the Arctic Circle and North Pole in the northern hemisphere, this area, okay. Arctic Circle is this and North Pole is this, so this area in northern hemisphere and this area means Antarctic Circle and South Pole in southern hemisphere are very cold. It is because the sun does not rise much above the horizon. ठीक है, यहाँ sun रहता है और यहाँ से यहाँ तक उसकी rays पहुँचने बहुत कम उसकी light पहुँच पाती है. And they are slanting. ठीक है, slanting like this. Okay. As in this picture you can say light is falling directly at 90 degree and here it is slanting. So when it is falling directly, it takes less area but strong light. Here it is slanting, it takes much area but very less intensity, okay. So same sun also behaves. So these two regions are known as frigid zones. I repeat, these two regions are frigid zones. So frigid zones are between Arctic Circles and North Pole in northern hemisphere and Antarctic Circle and South Pole in southern hemisphere. Longitudes, what are longitudes? As you can see in this picture, these lines are longitudes that are from North Pole to South Pole, these horizontal lines, okay. Lines of references running from North Pole to South Pole are called meridians to longitude. The distances between them are measured in degree of longitudes. Degree is further divided into minutes and minutes into seconds, okay. Distance between them decreases towards pole until it becomes zero at poles where all meridians meet. Yes, as you can see here, okay. As these meridians are going towards pole, okay, their distances are decreasing and at 90 degree they meet together. At poles, North Pole as well as South Pole, they meet together, okay? These are longitudes. So, you must have understood, okay? Parallels to equators, they are latitudes, and from North Pole to South Pole, they are longitudes. It means horizontal, they are latitudes, and vertical, they are longitudes. Prime meridian, yes. Meridian which passes through Greenwich, where the British Royal Society is located, it's 0° longitude. Okay, now it came the question, which meridian should be treated as 0°? 0° कहाँ से माना जाए, कहाँ से time की calculation start की जाए, okay? So, scientists decided that longitude that passes through the passes through the Greenwich. It is a place in Britain where British Royal Observatory is located. वहाँ पे ये observatory है, वहीं से time decide होता है. तो उन्होंने कहा जो यहीं से होके line जाती है उसी को हम लोग 0° treat करते हैं. और with the reference of the longitude, we'll start calculating the time. So, as you can see, this is your prime meridian and it is also known as 0°. As you can see, this prime meridian divides the globe, the earth, into two halves. This is your western half, this is your eastern half, this is your western half, this is your eastern half, okay? So, I repeat, equator divides the globe, the earth, into two halves, northern half and southern half. And prime meridian divides the earth into two halves, eastern halves and western half. So you can say northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere, okay? Longitude and time. When the prime meridian of Greenwich has the sun at the highest point in the sky, all the places along this meridian will have midday or noon. As the earth rotates west to east, places east of the Greenwich will be ahead of Greenwich time and those to the west will be behind. As the earth rotates 360° in 24 hours, so 15° in 1 hour and 1° in 4 minutes. Thus, when it is 12 noon at Greenwich, the time at 15° east of Greenwich will be 15 into 4 is equal to 60 minutes or 1 hour. Yes, this is your prime meridian, okay? When sun is just above prime meridian, means places falling on the line have noon, midday sun, okay? And this one is your 15°. So meridian at 15° will be 1 hour ahead, okay? Suppose it is here 12 o'clock, then here it would be 1 p.m. okay? Because as you can see, sun rotates, earth rotates 360° in 24 hours. So in 1 hour 15°, it means when sun travels 15° west to east, it is 1 hour difference, okay? And in 1°, it is 4 minutes difference, okay? So when it is 12 p.m. on prime meridian, so places falling on 15°, it will be 1 p.m., okay? Likewise, places west to the Greenwich will have 1 hour behind, means 11 a.m. I repeat, if there is 12 p.m. at Greenwich, then places 15° east will 1 pm and places 15 degree west will 1 hour behind means 11 am Indian standard time. Let's see what are Indian standard times. So eastern part of India touches 97 degree east longitude and western part touches 68 degree east longitude. Thus we take average, that is 82.5 degree east longitude. This meridian is our Indian standard time. It's 5 hour 30 minute ahead of Greenwich time. Yes, as you can see, this is your western part. Okay, this is your eastern part. You can see it is 68 degree east and 97 degree east. So if we take the average, it is 82.5 degrees. So 82 degree and half is taken as Indian standard meridian. So 82 degree half into 4 minutes. Why 4? Because 1 degree has 4 minutes different. So 82.5 degree, 82.5 into 4 is equal to 330 minutes or 5 hours 30 minutes. So Indian standard meridian is, or Indian standard time is 5 hours 30 minutes ahead of Greenwich time. It means when there is 12 pm in England, it is 5 pm 30. It means 5:30 pm in India. When suppose if a football match or a cricket match starts 1 pm in England, it would be 6:30 pm in India. Okay, the earth has been divided into 24 time zones of 1 hour each. Theek hai? So countries have a great longitudinal extent, so they have adopted more than one standard times. Russia has 11 standard times. Theek hai? Because Russia has very great extent, and one time zone is not good enough to calculate the time. So Russia has 11 standard times. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you.